Hi guys, Levi Powell here with the Digital Ag team at Iowa State University. Today we're out planting in the fields. We're putting some corn in the ground here the end of April, getting the last of our corn in before we switch over to some soybeans. We wanted to take a minute out of our afternoon and just talk to you guys about some of the metrics that are available on these newer planters, things that you can monitor both on the display of the planter and also on the iPad or any other viewing device that your system may have. So some of these newer systems, there's a lot of feedback now coming from the planter, and you may have an iPad similar to this, whether you have Precision Planting, Ag Leader, or Deere's Connect Mobile. There's a lot of information that can be gleaned from this, and sometimes people don't take the time to explore everything that's available. And so we just wanted to highlight a few things that may be useful to you guys when you're out in your planter this season as well. So one of the very first things that we always look at is singulation. And so as you're going through the field, you can start to look at singulation per each meter, and then also seed spacing. And those can help you identify any issues you may have on the planter, whether it's with a single row or some certain spots in the field that are causing some problems. The COV, seed spacing, is a good one to look at. And so you can kind of zoom in on different rows and see if you're having any issues consistently on one row. Here we've got one that may be having a small issue, but it's not consistent across the passes. So that's always a good metric to start out looking at as well. Another one that we like to look at quite often is our margin and applied downforce. So in this field here, we're targeting about 180 pounds of margin on our gauge wheels, which is similar to our last video when we talked about how to set the downforce. That's the load that we want the gauge wheels to carry. And so as we zoom out here, we can see that we're pretty consistent around our 180 margin target. And then the other interesting thing to look at along with that is the applied downforce. And so in this field, this is a no-till field that we're in today. And so this soil is pretty tight, it's a little bit harder, and it had a cover crop on it as well. And so we've got some residue to go through. And so you can see as we're going through different sections of the field here, that applied downforce is adjusting itself to keep our margin where we want it. And so this spot here was a drowned out. It's a little bit softer. And so the applied downforce backed off to keep our margin where we wanted it. And then in the rest of the field, you can see we've been up in that 300, 350 range for a good part of it. Interesting enough, we did till the outside of this field to get rid of some grain cart tracks and some other sprayer tracks and stuff. And so that shows up really easily where the planter was running in that tilled ground versus the no-till. You can see those differences. Even right here, there's a driveway where the sprayer's loaded in and out. You can see that spike in applied downforce. And so as you're planting your fields, these are interesting things that you can start to pull up and notice some different trends, through the field in different areas. The other one we really like to look at a lot is ride quality. And in this field, since we are running such a high downforce, our ride quality is a little bit rough because we're feeling all those bumps and tire tracks because those row units are pushing really hard into the ground. But as you zoom into some of the tilled area, you can see maybe there was one row there that was riding in a wheel track. And so those are things to look at as well. And so it's just interesting stuff as you're planting through to take time and scroll around and look at that stuff. And also on the applied downforce, if you wanted to really zoom in on something, you can change your legend to zoom in on things a little bit better, maybe tighten the legend up and just see how that, you know, changes the map for you a little bit to see if features will pop out a little bit more as you zoom in more to your working range with that legend. And so if we just bump that up here again on our applied downforce, for instance, and so you can see how some of these features start to pop a little bit differently. We see a little bit of streaking here, kind of at an angle across our passes. This is probably combine tracks from last fall. This field was soybeans, so it was harvested at an angle. And so as you're planting your fields, these are just things that you can be aware of. Just take time to play around with and check it out and see if you can learn anything new from your planter and the feedback that it offers you.